All right.
Hey, welcome to the Gopher CEO channel. I am the CEO of Gopher CEO, and I want to teach you some great things about business. You know, my traditional day-to-day is being in the business finance world, in the banking world, and then also personal finance. And that's one of the things that I've been able to really grow. And, you know, having had a chance to open up three businesses, one in the telecommunication space, one in the automotive space, and one recently in the financial world, you know, it's really important that you know how to get financing, right? You know, that's a big word. Cash is king. Cash flow is even kingier, right? So that's not really a word, but cash flow is king as well. So here's the thing, you know, when you start a business, there's really only a few ways that if you think about it, either you have cash because you've been able to save throughout the years and you're now ready with that idea and you're going to go out and start your own business. Then there's borrowing. Borrowing is really, is there some friends? Are there some family members? You know, can you put a GoFundMe account? Can you also do a Kickstarter fund? You know, these are all different ways to generate money that is in a lending capacity or even just almost a donation capacity with GoFundMe to start your own business. The last one is lending within the banking world, right? And just understanding the difference between two of the major components of lending. So I hope that over the next 5-6 minutes that I share with you this, that you'll get a better understanding within our channel. Not only are we talking to real business owners, you know, small entrepreneurs, start up to 25 million revenue, but then how do I get started with that money? Or if I'm currently in business, how do I go out and get my first loan? Or if I'm already established, but I'm not that credit worthy, I don't understand what to do. Well, what do I do, right? So here's a couple options. Number one is SBA. Number two is conventional, okay? Now, both of these will require that you share what's called a PFS, or personal financial statement. So this mirrors a lot of what you have currently been able to probably be familiar with in the just personal world, right? Your personal financial statement, although it's more based for businesses, is the same thing as your credit score in many ways with a conventional loan. But in a personal financial statement, we'll find out if you have assets, which is, do you own a home with equity in it? Do you own cars? Do you own other real estate? Do you own stocks, bonds, mutual funds? What does your personal financial statement say about you? Okay, that's the one big thing with when you're starting to get a loan. So make sure that your credit score is strong, but also make sure if you don't have any assets, you know, how could you structure something to be able to go after a loan, right? SBA is gonna be the Small Business Administration, Small Biz Admin, okay? And in this case, you know, they require really no experience. You know, they do give loans through a bank. All SBA loans usually go through a bank. The actual government doesn't give the specific loan. It always works through the bank. We're in 2020, and in March or April of that time, there was something called an SBA PPP loan. They did actually do their own loan, EIDL, right on their website, but the PPP, the Paycheck Protection Loan Program, did go through a bank, and that was where that guarantee was. So what the SBA does for banks is they usually guarantee about 75% of the loan. So if you think about it, you know, why would a bank give you a loan when you're first starting a business without any history of being in business? Maybe because it's a franchise that has a reputable model that has succeeded in the past. But most of the time, you're going to start a business that really has no experience, right? You may have actually worked in the industry of the type of business that you want to start. But again, to start a business, usually most banks aren't going to willy-nilly just give you money, right, to be able to start that business. They don't know if you're going to succeed. So they want that 75% guarantee from the SBA, the government entity, the Small Business Administration. So that's one of the things that is really great about the SBA. Also, usually about 10% skin in the games, 10%, right, down payment. You know, we all know from the personal loans that we've talked about, or people talk about with mortgages like FHA and all that type of stuff, 3% or 20% conventional. But yeah, same thing. 10% is kind of usually the rough number that people will have, that you'll have to have to start your own business. So if you were looking for $100,000, for $35,000, and $35,000, you'll need about $3,500 to $4,000 with some fees to be added on to there as well. Or $100,000, you'll need about $10,000. So hopefully that helps you. That's the SBA side. Let's go conventional and we'll wrap up the video. So conventional is usually when you've been in business for over 2 years, or you are in business and you're looking to expand, you're looking to merger, acquire, M&A, right? Mergers and acquisitions. These are the types of traditional ways that a conventional loan will be. These are usually higher interest rates, right? This on the SBA usually is upwards of maybe 5% or so. And then conventional usually has been between the 3s and 4s. So that means that you could save some money on your types of interest on your loans. Sometimes the length of time can be very beneficial with certain banks. Some banks use business loans only as 5-year terms, and then you have to renew, some at 10, some at 15, and there's even some at 20 and 25 years. So check with your bank, check that relationship, and see what kind of products and services they can do at conventional. But conventional will need 20%, at least as a minimum. And if the financials of your business aren't as strong, then it'll probably need a little bit more, maybe 25, 30% cash injection, cash deposit to be able to start or increase that business. So what types of loans are there too, right? There's working capital or conventional, right? Conventional, just let's say equipment loan, or purchase of real estate. So real estate. So these are types of loans that you will be able to get with a conventional loan. Again, around 20% deposit. Deposit. So personal financial statements. These are the types of loans. And then lastly, what do you also need? You're gonna need 3 years of tax returns, business and personal tax returns. You're going to need stuff like, if you run a business, what's called an aging report of your account receivables or your accounts payables, right? These are ways that the bank can see, you know, hey, what kind of clients do you have? How fast do they pay you? How much do you owe in debt? How about a balance sheet? A balance sheet shows, you know, your assets and your liabilities. You know, do you have more balances and assets, or do you have more liabilities, right? That could be a deterrent of a bank wanting to borrow you more money. Then there's also interim financials, right? Which is basically year to date. You know, if it's right now, it's November, the last quarter ended in September. How did you do? What was the gross revenue on that business from January to September? How much net profit are you having in your business? Meaning after all expenses, salaries and cost of goods sold and all these types of things, how much are you netting? And then there's this last little part. So let me give you the big aha secret, okay? Here's the secret, ladies and gentlemen, of what banks do to really determine, and it's kind of a lending lingo called debt coverage ratio. So DCR, debt coverage ratio. Basically, this means after everything's said and done, okay, let's just say you're doing about $300,000 in business and you're like, man, I need to buy something for $78,000. Well, if you can't cover it with your debt coverage ratio, debt service coverage ratio, some people call it, you are not getting the loan. It's kind of like saying debt to income ratio on your personal life, right? If you have too much debt with cars and home loans and stuff like that, you're probably not going to be able to get another loan to get yet another thing. But debt coverage ratio in a business is supremely important. So talk to your accountant, talk to your CFO or your outsourced CFO. I know a guy, he's on my channel. We've interviewed him, Matt Wilmy. But debt coverage ratio is supremely important. And how does that come up? Okay, let's just say you're doing $300,000 in gross revenue, right? And you've got maybe a 15% margin, right? So you're talking about $4,500 of profit, okay? And that's called a year, okay? Well, if you take that, that's about $400 a month, okay? And if you're asking for a debt, a piece of debt that is going to cost you, okay, let's just say $200 a month to finance, then that's, right, that's double. That's 2 to 1, okay? If it's $400 that it's going to cost you, so you're making this in profit, you're available on a monthly basis to service, to debt coverage ratio, to service your debt is $400 a month, but the loan you want to get is $400, that's 1 to 1, all right? Most banks are going to want a 1.25% debt coverage ratio. So this is a huge, huge thing, all right, ladies and gentlemen. If you are starting a business, if you just are running a business and you're adding debt, just know that work with your accountant, work with a business banking professional to find out what your debt coverage ratio is, and don't spin your wheels. If you can't get to that 1.25, you're probably not at a point where you're going to want to lend money to yourself or get money. And try to watch out for the sharks out there. Obviously, there's other ways to get money than just banks and SBA, but that could be very painful when those interest rates start hitting you. And they may give you the money, and you may want to take that risk, but unfortunately, you may be overpaying compared to other conventional lending practices. So hope this helps. Just getting started in my YouTube channel and sharing with you different ideas, the business, the mindset. We're going to talk about mindset in other videos. We're going to talk about other strategies of marketing and operations in your business. So I'm excited to be here with you. And thank you so much for coming on to the Go for CEO channel. Take care.